A mighty powerful spacewalk outside the space station, a look at the space station's next crew, and updates on our Artemis program. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On July 1st, our Chris Cassidy and Bob Behnken were outside the International Space Station for their second spacewalk in less than a week.
You have control of the batteries. I do. I'm in a good spot.
The pair continued upgrading power systems on the station, replacing aging nickel hydrogen batteries with new lithium ion batteries. The battery upgrades are expected to continue on future spacewalks, with target dates and times to be announced once mission planners assess the scope of the remaining work to be done.
You really feel it when you arrive at the space station and see this hardware and see these modules put together and flying in space. It's one of the most incredible engineering achievements, I think, that humanity has done.
NASA astronaut Kate Rubins discussed her upcoming second mission to the space station during a July 1st press conference at our Johnson Space Center in Houston. She was joined by Sergei Ryzhikov and Sergei Kuzmichkov of the Russian space agency Roscosmos. The trio is targeted to launch to the station October 14th from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. NASA is working with contractor Northrop Grumman on building Space Launch System solid rocket boosters to support as many as 6 additional flights for a total of up to 9. Northrop Grumman is the current lead contractor for the boosters that will launch the first 3 Artemis missions, including the one that will land the first woman and next man on the moon in 2024. We've wrapped up testing on the Orion structural test article, a twin copy of the spacecraft needed to verify Orion is ready for Artemis 1. The testing, which began in early 2017, was designed to thoroughly evaluate Orion's ability to withstand the stresses of launch, climb to orbit, harsh conditions of deep space transit, and return to Earth. Engineers completed the Space Launch System rocket's structural testing campaign for Artemis missions by applying millions of pounds of force to the rocket's liquid oxygen structural test tank. The tank failed within the parameters expected, proving flight readiness and providing critical data. The SLS rocket, Orion spacecraft, Gateway, and human landing system are part of NASA's backbone for Artemis, our next step in human space exploration. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.